Beautiful. Okay. Moreover, Rabotai, our show tonight, Kshushan, Zenon Nishmat Eish HaKasher, Shinfta B'Shem Tov L'Olam, Mula, Betzalel Ben Rivka, Ruach Hashem Dechenu Magan Eden, Tiyeh Nishmato Tzura B'Tzura Chaim. Our show Torah is going to be להצלחת כל אחד ואחד מכם. May God will give you a long life, and a healthy life, and a happy life. We're going to hear among all of you, כל ששון וכל שמחה, כל חתן וכל קלה, וכן יהי רצון ונאמר אמן. Today the topic is נטילת ידיים. The obligation that one is supposed to have when he's washing his hand. As many, during the days, as many events and many incidents that a person have to wash his hand. We're going to touch some of them and we're going to touch the reason behind, and the more important is the message. The first one is when a person wake up in the morning. When a person wake up in the morning, we wash in the hand. How do you wash the hand in the morning? You take the negel vaser and the right side, you move it to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? And then we have another time is before your person is going to eat. Before you're going to eat, memorize for the Kohanim that used to wash themselves before they eat terumah, שהיו אוכלים terumah בתארה. They used to eat the food being pure. נטילת ידיים symbolize a person to become pure because of that, because of before food, before men food. What is men? Men meaning the most important part of food is bread. A person have to wash his hand. Beautiful. And then we have another time when we're going into the bathroom. The difference between the morning and the food and the bread to the one later on, when a person go to the bathroom, when a person, now not necessary if you had bathroom. Even if you just walk in and walk out, it's good to wash the hand from a bathroom. Bathroom is considered to be makom tum'ah. The only difference is that you don't do beracha. You don't do asher yatzar. Asher yatzar you do only if you're going out to do a bathroom. But just to walk into the room, you don't have to do asher yatzar. Now, also when a person touch any place that is usually covered, meaning shoes, your hair, if you scratch it, not if you just touch it, if you scratch your hair, if you touch places that usually cover during the summer, during the winter, I'm sorry, usually cover during the day, and you touched it. Before tefillah is very important. It's not obligation, but very important for among Hasidim and also among Litvishes. They are very, very meticulous to wash their hands before tefillah. Now, what's the reason that we wash in hand? You see, the Shulchan Aruch said in Masechet Brachot, we studied the death of Gemara, and we all know that Netilat Yadayim is one of the reasons, once we spoke about it, I'm not going to repeat it so much, but Netilat Yadayim, Segula La'ashirut, or La'aniyut. Either to become rich, or either to become poor. If a person wants to become rich, or if a person, God forbid, trying to avoid himself to become poor, one of the things to do, according to the Zohar, and according to the Gemara is, be careful to wash your hand. You know, one of the reasons that is no parnasa, one of the reasons that is difficult, the Gemara brings many reasons. One of them is taking a bread, leftover of the bread and throw it. It's not only minag, it's not good for money-wise. Because when you mezalzen in parnasa, when you're not careful in parnasa, the Almighty God will not be careful in parnasa as well, with your own parnasa. But one of the reasons, one of the things, washing hand, how do you know that? So the Zohar Kadosh brings a story that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, when his own son, Rabbi Elazar, saw a man, a Talmid Chacham, that was become a servant, I believe, of Rabbi Chiya. And Rabbi Elazar, the son, didn't like it. He said, I mean, I don't understand. I see that you're so smart. You're such a brilliant person. Just talking to you, just see your face, you look like a smart man. Well, how come you become a servant? So he told them the story that a different rabbi came and he took his position, he took the job. So Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hu told Rabbi Elazar Baruch Hu was screaming to his father, Abba, Abba, I want this one. I mean, he needs parnasa, meaning bless him with parnasa. The father was smart enough, Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hu, one of the most holy people in the world, and he gave him a hint. And he told him, listen, If anyone here is going to wash his hand and is going to be careful to do netilat yadayim bekavana ubeharchava, meaning beharchava with unlimited water, not to be cheap in water, to do it and to do it right, left, right, left, right, to do it right, guaranteed to become rich. That person washed the hand, and right where the Zohar Kadosh right, he find a stone, a diamond stone next to him. And that's it. He opened yeshiva and he stopped working. He started to teach. He started to teach back. Natalia, one of the ways to become wealthy is be careful. And until that time, how do you know that? So one time we said, because the wood, which beracha we doing when we wash the hand? Shai, which beracha we doing when we wash the hand?
What?
No, this is for the bread. Al, netilat, yadayim. What's the first letter of al? Ein. Netilat, nun. Yadayim? Together?
Ani.
Ani, poor man. You see? If you're going to be careful, you will never become poor. And I will give you another proof. The word, male yadenu mi birkotecha. Please God, fill up our hand with your own blessing. One of the greatest blessings, right? One of the greatest blessings. Fill up our hand with your unlimited blessing. Amazing pasuk. What's the first word of this pasuk? Male? Mem. Yadenu? Yud. Mi birkotecha? Mem, yud, mem? Mine. Beautiful. Water give you to get unlimited blessing from the Almighty God. So when you're going to go back home, not only that you're going to be makpidim and netilat yadayim, and today we're going to study why. This is only introduction. Not only that you're going to be makpidim, you're going to know how to share with your friends. Wash your hand. When a person is coming to you and said, Rabbi, I have issue in Parnasa. So one of the ways is to tell him to be very careful in Berkat HaMazon. Berkat HaMazon is also segula leparnasa, to wealth. Muftachno, shelo yelo chaser mamon. Shelo yichsar lo mamono boto yom. Sefer HaChinuch Ra'id. Sefer HaChinuch Ra'id, when you make, and we spoke about it in a different class, that if you make, if you are makpid in Berkat HaMazon, you guarantee to have unlimited parnasa. But now we study another things. Washing hand. Washing hand is guarantee. So if you see a person in an upstick and a knife, tell him to wash hand. But what is the reason that we wash hands, especially in the morning? In the morning is the most important. From all the netilat yadayim that we're doing, in the morning is the most important. So much that we don't do tefillah. We don't put tefillin. Many things we don't do, we're trying to avoid if we didn't wash the hand. Except one item. Which items you can do before you wash your hand? Which items we do before we wash the hand?
Modani.
Modani, why?
Because there's no Hashem.
Beautiful. One simple explanation is, there's no Hashem. God doesn't appear. It's not God. The name of God is not there. Modani, lefanecha melech, lechav v'kayom. Beautiful. This is the simple explanation. But when you come into BJCC, Yud Minyan Torah Tefillah, a place that considered to be family, a place that inspires our mind and our heart, a place that makes difference in the people's life, when you come in here, you're going to hear a little dip. The second reason is, Shemodei ani shel Yehudi, shum tum'ah lo yichola lakacht. The modei ani, the essence of a Jew, will never become impure. Will never become impure. The body might become impure, but the neshama, the soul, the thank you, the essence of a Jew, This word is from the Lubavitcher Rebbe. Will never be, because of that, you can see it, you can say it before washing hand. Okay? But what's the reason we wash the hand? Cohen, do you know what's the reason that we wash the hand? I will share with you today 4 or 5 reasons and then message behind each one of them. Message behind each one of them. Simple explanation in halacha and then message. The first thing שאומרת הגמרא מסכת ברכות דף סמך עמוד א' עמוד ב' when you in a person wake up in the morning you have obligation to wash your hand and after you have obligation to wash your hand you do ברכה. You see, when you're going out from the bathroom, when you touch shoes, when you scratch your head, do you do ברכה על נטילת ידיים? The only twice that is obligation to wash the hand is before food and before in the morning. How do you know that? Because the act himself get his own beracha. The act himself is not enough that you bless the food. You have to bless before al netilat yadayim, right? So the netilah himself get their own beracha. Just to show you that this is obligation. Asher kidishanu b'mitzvotav. The one that makes us holy with his own mitzvot. Beautiful. What is the reason? Shai, הטעם הראשון מבואר בזוהר הקדוש, שבשעה שישן האדם בלילה, מסתלקת ממנו הנשמה הטהורה, ותואם טעם מוות, ורוח רעה שורה על גופו, וכשחוזרת הנשמה לגוף, בקומו משנתו נשארת הרוח הרעה על ידיו, וכדי להעבירה צריך ליטול ידיו. רבותיי, the first reason is, when you go into sleep at night, you're going to sleep at night, or when you're going to sleep period, when you're going to sleep period, your soul, most of the part of the soul, leave the body. The soul leave the body. Because of that, when you wake up in the morning, the first thing that you say is, מודה אני לפניך. מלך לחי וקיים, שחזרת בי נשמתי. Thank you, the Almighty God, that you bring me back. You bring my soul back to my body. Now, if I'm going to ask you, what's the reason that a person is sleeping? That this is a good to sleep, is bad to sleep? What's the reason we're sleeping? If somebody is going to ask you, this is a good to sleep or bad to sleep?
Good.
Good, right? For some people it's bad, losing time. But most of us, we like to sleep. So this is good or bad? Definitely good. I will tell you, even spirituality is good. Because during the days, the person doing so many decisions, sometimes bad, sometimes horrible, sometimes depression come, sometimes he's so upset with himself, sometimes you're losing a huge amount of money, sometimes a person is doing so many avirot. In order to make a break between, and to give you opportunity to be mitchadesh, to wake up like a fresh person, like a brand new person, that you realize when you wake up in the morning, you feel new chayut. Even though that last yesterday was a horrible day, a very challenging day, you wake up in the morning, Vashkem Avraham Baboker, you wake up and you feel, wow, a new day, is new passion. What exactly happened? The neshama of a human being pass cleaners. You know these cleaners, the machine, the clothing become brand new every night. Our neshama do two things. First of all, the neshama give din v'cheshbon. Every night when your soul is going up, she's making a signature. You know when you're going out to the job or any place, you have to sign your names. Every night the neshama sign for everything that you did in that day. This way after 120 years, they're going to show you your own signature. When you're going to say, I did it, it was not me. I'm sorry, this is your signature? Every night you sign, this is what you did. Every night when we're going up to Shamayim, we sign for our own deeds. So we have a din v'cheshbon in a daily basis, in a nightly basis, okay? Second thing is, the neshama is going up. Why the neshama is going up? To give us opportunity to be mitchadesh. To have a cleanness to the soul. But when the neshama leaves the body, like everything empty. Everything empty. We studied last week that if you're coming into churva, churva meaning a house that nobody was living over there, what do you have to do? You have to be very careful. Why? Because the chitzonim, bad sources jump in, evil sources. Because of that, Netanel is so dangerous to go into churva. Okay. Now, when the neshama is leaving the body, the evil sources jumping in. When they're jumping in, when the neshama is coming back, most of it is leaving. But some of it staying still, where? Bekapot ha'yadayim or batzipronayim, nails. Because of that, you will never see chassidim with big nails. Nails is not something good. Most of the bad sources remain in the nails. So because of that chassidim, you will never see chassid that have nails bigger from the hand. You know, also when you see witches, you know the witches? When you have an idea of a witch, witch, machshava. Machshava, a bad woman, right? Witch. What exactly do you have in mind? Which picture? a woman with big nails, right? He said, maybe it's the reason. Most of the bad souls, most of the evil souls remain in the hand, and especially, and because of that, when you wake up in the morning, you wash your hand. You wash your hand, you purify that evil source. You take away the tum'ah. Tum'ah that might be in our generation, we don't see, we don't feel, maybe, but it exists. It exists. Chazal, our sages want to protect us from all the evil source. How do you do it? Wash your hand. First reason. Second reason is, Gemara Masechet Shabbat, that the night, not the sleeping, the night is the cost of the even inclination. The night, every time you pass night, even if you didn't sleep. You see, the second reason is, even if you didn't sleep, the night bring tuma. So you need to have a ruach ra, an evil spirit to go away from you. Night is a time of the evil spirit. Okay? Number three, the Rosh. The Rosh meaning Rabbeinu Asher. I love him very much. He said that the third reason is because at night when you're sleeping, your hand is very busy hand. Did you realize that as long as you're awake, you can control your hand where to go? If you don't want to scratch, you don't scratch. At night, you don't control yourself. When you need to scratch, what do? Automatically. Trrr. You need to touch something in the body, especially if you sleep with the boxer. And some people sleep free, with no... Yeah, no,
Margishim
Babayit.
Eh?
Border suit, yes, beautiful. Sarot, the garden. I call it the gardens. You know the gardens? The gardens. They have gardens and they're scratching all night and touching places. This way, Yadayim Askaniyot, when a person is awake, he can have the ability to control. But when you're not awake, some people, they're carousel. You know carousel? Like a ride. How do you call this ride? This carry ride?
Roller coaster.
When they sleep, you see the guy is moving like a watch. Boom, bam. They get in punching, moving with the head. Balagan, you know. So when a person sleeps at night, usually his hand is not in his control. Because of that, okay. Number four, Arashba. When you wake up in the morning, a person becomes new Bria. New Bria. In the same way that Chadashim Lebkarim, Rabbi Emunatecha. Every morning, God made me to become new. And if I become new, I have to thank Hashem. Now I'm washing hands in order to thank Hashem for giving me a new soul, new Beria. Number five, with that one we're going to conclude. Abu Dram Rukotev, Shekeshem Shakuanim Tzichim Lichotz Yadayim, Kodem Avodat Ben HaMikdash, used to be tradition. A Kohen, before he came to pray, before he came to serve God, before he came to give a korban, they used to wash the hand, right? Kohen, they used to wash the hand. We are coming to tefillah. We have to wash our hand. You see? Okay, this is five reasons. Now we're going to get five messages to our life.
One and four is one the same.
What was it?
One and four is one the same.
Which one?
The one sleeping and the Briyat HaDasha, they look sound the same.
No. The first one is, number one is, because of Tum'ah. Tum'ah. At night, you have, not at night, sleeping cause Tum'ah. The second one is, Briyat HaDasha. Have nothing to do with negativity. The fact that your soul is coming back is Beria Chadasha. Okay? Now we have five reasons. I was about to tell you something, one second. It was a guy that used to study in the Kollel. Used to study in the Kollel on a daily basis, all day long for 6 months, study only Torah. Avi, the guy was a righteous man. And, you know, he did everything fast, and he was learning, and going home, helping his wife, doing everything according to the book. One day he came to his wife. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Shehakol Nehiya Bedvaro.
Amen.
One day he came to his wife, he said, my dear wife, you don't understand, last night I had a dream, a good dream. What's the good dream? He said, last night, I'm walking in to the palace of the Almighty God. And God accepted me. And I spoke with Hashem. I spoke with Hashem. And God was listening to me until the end. Do you understand what you mean? I spoke with Hashem. Now, usually when you tell a person that you spoke with God, what usually you accept to hear from the person?
Ridicule.
Eh?
Ridicule.
What is it? Baba Sali, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Rabbi Meir Baal Hanes. They are all of them is nothing. Eliyahu Navi is no, is nothing like that. You are greater from Eliyahu Navi, Malach Michael. Right away. But you know, usually you're going to hear it from somebody, it's not from your wife. Your wife is always honest. She's always going to come to tell you the truth. Listen to what this wife responded. Cohen was a person that came to the Lubavitcher Rebbe. He came to the Rebbe. And he shared to the Rebbe what he shared with other people. What? His own son, you remember the story, used to put everything that he had, he used to put, like tefillin. Even the logo. Instead of playing with the logo, he put the logo like tefillin. Boxes, he had the boxes, he put the boxes, anything that he saw, he put it like tefillin. So every rabbi that he went, the rabbi told him, wow, you are tzaddik. Maybe your son is going to become like Rashi HaKadosh. Maybe he's going to become Rabbeinu Tam. Maybe he's going to have another opinion, another shita. They made him, you know what the Lubavitcher Rebbe told him? The Lubavitcher Rebbe, quietly, but in a nice, when you come to Rebbe, you hear him it. When you come to your own rabbi, you accept to hear emet, not only compliment. To hear the emet, you know what the Rebbe told him? Cohen, listen to this. The Rebbe told him, maybe it's a time for you to stop praying at home and to start to pray in the synagogue. You got the message? You know why his son always to put the tefillin? Because every day he sees his father pray at home. So he sees the tefillin all day long. So the Rebbe told him, maybe it's a time for you to pray in minyan instead of being righteous in the house. And then your son will see less tefillin. Not all day long, he's going to see you walking with tefillin. Maybe. So the wife told the husband, when he came to her and said, my dear wife, I saw God and Hashem. The wife told him, my dear husband, God is listening to you every day three times. Why you need to dream about it? Every day when you're coming into Shmona Esre, three times a day, and you pray, Hashem Sefatai Tiftach, who are you talking to? You're talking with God. God is not listening. So why do you need to see in a dream, Eliyahu HaNavi, Rabbi Shimon Bar? Every day you're speaking with God. Maybe it's a time for you, my dear husband, to take the tefillah a little more seriously. To pray a little more slowly. To have a little more kavana when you're praying, because Hashem is listening to you. The husband had tears in his eyes. From this moment, his prayer was never the same. He never spoke. He never put the phone in a vibrate. He was praying devoted. Now let's go in to these five messages to our life. The first message of the washing hand is very, very simple. When you're going in to sleep at night, when you're going to sleep, you become impure. You have to wash your hand. Or when you're going at night to sleep, night causes you to become impure. You have to wash your hand. Maybe the message for us from these two reasons, either night or either sleeping, that no matter what you had in life, many times a person told you, Rabbi, I'm in a darkness moment in my life. Darkness moment in my life. You know what I pass? You know where I fell down? Rabbi Nachman Breslev used to say, Keshem she'adata she'efshar lekalkel. Teda, she'efshar letaken. The same way that you know how to ruin. Remember that you have the ability to fix. Remember that you have the ability to fix. You hear that? The same way that you know how to ruin. The same way that you know how to sleep. Sleeping meaning a person that doesn't do a lot. Losing time. Going to sleep. A person that going at night meaning symbolize the darkness. The avirut that a person did. Remember that you can fix. Wash hand, wake up in the morning, wash hand, and remember you can fix it. One message. Second message is, according to the Rosh, Yadayim Askaniyot. You know what I mean, Yadayim Askaniyot? If there's anything that we have to do, to have to remember is to do honest business. The first question that they're going to ask you after 120 years is what? Nasata venatata be'emuna. That you did honest business? That you did the business in a kosher way? Usually, how exactly we steal? With which part of the body? With the hand. You have to wash your hand. Every morning you have to remind yourself, make sure that the hand is going to be pure. Because the hand as kaniyot, they are moving, they are doing. The same way at night, you don't have control where the, which part of the body they're going to touch, the same way during the days. You have to make sure that your hand will not go to places that they don't need. Wash the hand. What a beautiful message is that. You know why you're washing the hand? The first thing is to let you know that no matter how far you went down, you always can fix yourself. The second message is, remember, the most important things in a person's body, in a person's life is doing honest business. And honest business usually we do with our hand. So before you transfer money, before you take something, before you're doing, God forbid, something bad, wash the hand. You wake up in the morning, and you know, when a person tells you, I'm clean. Somebody came to me and said, Rabbi, Le'avdil elef efe avdalot. This is not a good example, but I will still say it. Even in a casino, when people playing next to the card, what are the guy that making the card is doing? What are they doing? The first thing is, right? It's an obligation, you know that. Why? I'm not hiding any card. It's all kosher. Nothing is kosher. It's the cook is paying place, but he's clean. His hand is clean, so to speak. You hear that? Cohen, you hear that? Wow. A person have to wash his hand because business have to be kosher. And it's so nice to speak with you, Cohen, because I know that your business is kosher. B'li Einara, the way that you handle business, B'li Einara, thank God. You deserve to have a blessing. May God will bless you for everything that you're doing, physical and spiritual, especially business-wise, to open all the doors upon you and upon your family. And let us say amen. Number four. שבבוקר נעשה אדם בריאה חדשה. You know why we wash in hand? To remind us two things. First of all, I'm a new person. A new person is a good thing to do, to remember. You know why? Because I remember one time I went in Florida, and I asked a person, after I spoke with him, a little divrei Torah, do you want to put the tefillin? He said, Rabbi, did you want to know what I did last night? I said, okay, what is the connections? I said, you know, our sages already teach us. Schar mitzvah, mitzvah. And schar avera, avera. There's no connection between mitzvah and avera, and one second a person can become from being the worst rasha to the greatest tzaddik. One second. One foot of teshuvah. One act of good deeds can change your status completely. So when a person wake up in the morning, he said, Rabbi, I did last night this and this. Yesterday I did this and this. What? Behemet, you think that I really can change? Yes, you are Beriyah Chadasha. God every morning give you the power. Not only the power to be happy, not only the power to forget about your wrong mistakes business-wise, the power to forget what you did yesterday, behave-wise, character-wise, or sin-wise. You hear that? Because sometimes a person wake up and they say, no, I cannot change. This is me. Accept me the way I am. I cannot change. My habit is to become poor, stingy. My nature is to become lazy. This is my nature. Every day God gives you a new neshama to remind all of us, you can change. You definitely can change. This is not you. I'm giving you every day the ability to make a change in your life. Wow. This is the power of Netilat Yadayim. The power of Netilat Yadayim is to remind a human being what you did yesterday have nothing to do with what you're doing today. You know why? You're a new human being. And that one is important to remember. And last but not least, Keshem Shehakohanim. And also, by the way, and also to say thank you to Hashem. You know, why do you say thank you with the hand? Why do you say thank you with the hand? When we wish parnasa, poteach et yadecha, right? We pick up our hand. Su yadechem lamarom, ureu mibara, open your hand. When you see tzaddikim, when they pray, they open the hand. When you say thank you to Hashem, usually, thank you Hashem, right away you see, always in the picture you see a person with it. Why? Because if somebody will ask you, Tzvi, what is the highest part of the body? Which part of the body is the highest one? What are you going to say right away? What?
Your head.
Your head, beautiful, the brain. Because of that, in the shower, you have to put your head first, out of kavod. But it's not the tshuva, it's not right. You know which part of the body is the highest? Your hand. Why? Which part of the body is you see? Very simple. Because of that, in Pesach, what do we do after we do Kadesh? You remember, Kadesh, Uchatz, Karpas, Yachatz. What do we do? Kadesh, Uchatz. In Pesach, we wash twice the hand. Twice washing. Because nothing is important for wash. Before you start to become religious, before you begin, you're going in to Megid, to say stories, Chidushin, wash your hand. Wash the highest part of your body is the hand. This is the reason. To say thank you, we say with the hand. To ask something from God, we do it with the hand. The hand is so important. God give us a new neshama. God give us like Biriyah Chadasha. You wake up in the morning, you have to say thank you to Hashem, and you have to remember that today I can do everything that I want, completely different from what I did yesterday. Why? I'm a new human being. I'm a new person. Bri'ah Chadasha. And last but not least, we said that Abu Dhram, the same way that the Kohanim, before they serve God, they wash in the hand, the same way the Jewish nation, Rabotai, v'atem tiuli mamlechet Kohanim. Maybe washing the hands symbolizes each one of us that you're not a simple person. You are Kohen Gadol. You're not a simple human being. Many times the reason that we not succeed in life, the reason that we're not moving forward in life, because we think, who I am? I'm nobody. I'm nobody. Be'emet, ma ani kvar yachol la'asot? Business-wise and religious-wise. If Rabbi Akiva came with this attitude, he will never become Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva, his father was a kavod human being, a kavod. Until today, if somebody will come to you and a woman, she's going to say, I'm a kavod woman. Are you going to get married? Are you going to date her very easy? Right away, you put brakes. Right, kavod? What exactly is wrong with me? I'm so bad to get married with kavod? Tell me, is anything bad to get married with kavod? I mean, David the Melech came from Kanvot. Rabbi Akiva came from Kanvot. Melech HaMashiach came from Kanvot. But this is the stigma. The stigma meaning, this is the attitude. Right away, attitude. We have attitude. Rabbi Akiva came from a Kanvot Moshe. And he also had, no, I'm going to become Gadol Israel. I'm going to become the greatest rabbi in the generation. There's no way. There's no way. I will never be able to do it. But he never had such an attitude. He said, no. God gave me a son and I'm the greatest. I am the greatest. You know which level Rabbi Akiva came? We do, gentlemen, you don't realize. And which level Rabbi Akiva became? Rabbi Akiva replaced God. Rabbi Akiva replaced God. You know what it means to replace God? Et Hashem Elokecha tira, uve'ahavta et Hashem Elokecha. Love you, God. Fear you, God. Why the word et? Et usually in Hebrew is also. Love, also God. Fear, also. Why also? Why also? Also who? Also meaning adding. We add who? You know what Rabbi Akiva said? Talmid Chacham. A rabbi, you have to love him. The same way that you love God, you have to love your own rabbi. The same way that you have a fear of God, you have to have a fear from your own rabbi. Beautiful, right? Amazing. How did Rabbi Akiva know about it? Uren, how did Rabbi Akiva know about it? How did he know The Talmid Chacham is almost in the same level of the Almighty God.
Rabbi
Akiva knew that, but how did, why only him? How did he know? You know that nobody knew this Chiddush until Rabbi Akiva came? And he said, "Ve'afta et Hashem." You know, "Ekabed et avicha ve'et imecha." Shai, what is et? Come to add, "Kabed," honoring your father and mother. That's it. Father and mother. What is et? Et lerabot ach bechor v'achot bechora. Your older brother, you have to respect him. Why? The word et appear next to the father. You hear that? Your older sisters, you have to respect the word et next to the mother. So when I say you have to love God, ve'afta et Hashem Elokecha, et come to add. Add what? Rabbi Akiva said, add rabbis, talmidei chachamim. How did Rabbi Akiva know about it? Beautiful, but how did he know about it? How do you know that you can put rabbis and God and almost in the same level? It's almost chutzpah to say it. Rabotai, Rabbi Akiva was once of what? Once of what? When he died, why did Rabbi Akiva die? He was once of... One of the people, how many people?
Six.
No, how many people? How many people die in the time of Rabbi Akiva? And they die because of what?
Because they have no communication with each other.
There's no support.
Beautiful, but no. This is the student.
Lack of respect.
No, it was 10 rabbis that die. The greatest 10 rabbis in the world history, and they die in a horrible ways. Why these 10? Why 10? Rabotai, the king of that generation, came to Rabbi Ishmael Kohen Gadol, and he told them, "Rabbi Ishmael, we have to kill you and 10 different rabbis. And we have to kill you and 10 different rabbis." So, Rabbi, 10 of them, and one of them is Rabbi Akiva. Now, I will ask you, why 10? Because how many people saw Yosef at Tzaddik? The king came to Rabbi Ishmael and said, the Torah said, "Ugonev ishu mecharo mot yumat." If you steal a Jewish man and you sold them, what is your punishment? To die. How many people saw yourself? 10. And nobody died till today. So the king said, "Listen, I am a messenger of God. I have to kill you. You said that the judgment is to die. I have to kill." 10 rabbis has been chosen. The greatest 10 rabbis in the world history. Each one of them represent different tribes from the Jewish nation. Now, how many people was in the Senate? By the way, let's see. I'm teaching you something tonight. How many people was in the Senate? How many people literally saw Yosef at Tzaddik? Binyamin was not exist. Yosef is not a part. He's not a part. They saw him. Okay, so we already have 10. So left 10. Binyamin. Reuven was not there. Gentlemen, Reuven was not there. Now, in order to have a court, you have to have 10 people. So you know what the sages said? The 9 tribe had God with them. They brought God to become a partner in the judgment, to sell yourself. And Hashem agreed to this judgment. Oh. Now, Rabbi, so we have 10 rabbis that replace the 10. Now, my question is very simple. Rabbi Akiva cannot replace, you know why? He is convert. Replace who? Each one of them replace one. I understand. This guy came from Yehuda, he replaced Yehuda. This guy came from Reuven, he replaced. Rabbi Akiva, so who Rabbi Akiva replaced? You know who? The Almighty God. You remember that it was only 9, number 10 was God. Rabbi Akiva said, if I came to replace God, meaning, loving God, meaning, you have to love Talmid Chacham. Yeah. Huh? This is deep. This is the reason. We wash in hand because we have to remember that you're not a simple human being. You can achieve business-wise, relationship-wise, and especially spirituality-wise, anything you want. Why? Like a Kohen Gadol. Don't act with yourself like a nobody. You are the holy priest. The same way that Kohanim used to wash their hand, the same way every morning you remind yourself, I am a Kohen, and I can achieve everything that I want in life. Hopefully we're going to take this message to our life, and God will help all of us to achieve all our goals and desires. And let us say amen.